Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss academic reading mock test number 11 passage 3. And see here are the instructions given here. So they have given total 28 to 40 questions in this passage, and for this 28 to 40 we have to spend about 20 minutes. And these 28 to 40 questions have divided like this, like questions 28 to 31, these are like paragraph headings. And next second set of questions 30 to 35, these are like matchings. And the third set of questions 36 to 40, these are yes, no, not given. Now we will discuss each type of questions in detail. Look at first set of questions, these are called paragraph headings. So here they have given some sections or paragraphs, and for these sections you have to choose one heading from the given list of headings. And if you see here, already in example they have given for section B, yes, heading number 8. What is heading number 8 here? Heading number 8 is sustainable economic development. Already this heading is used for section B. The same heading we should not repeat for any of the remaining sections. So please strike off heading number 8. And from the remaining headings we have to choose for the remaining paragraphs. Look at question number 28. What is question number 28 here? Question number 28 is section A. So please read section A. And most of the times in the paragraph headings, the answer may be given either at the beginning or at the ending of the paragraph. If you see here, every health system in an economically developed society is faced with the need to decide either formally or informally what proportion of the community's total resources should be spent on health care, how resources are to be apportioned, what diseases and disabilities and which forms of treatment are to be given priority, which members of the community are to be given special consideration. If you see, there are so many interrogatives. There is some questions actually. So if you look at the headings, so first one, the connection between healthcare and other human rights, there is no proper information about human rights. Next, the development of market-based, then there is no information about market-based health systems. Next, the role of the state, there is no information about state. Next, a problem shared by every economically developed country. Okay, some resemblance is there, because here the problem is nothing but they're asking like what proportion of the community, here see what proportion. Next, what are the diseases and disabilities and which forms of treatment, maybe. Just hold it. Next, the impact of recent changes. There is no information about recent change. And the views of the medical, no information about medical establishment. The end of an illusion, no information. Already this is the eliminated. So most probably the best one is heading number 4. A problem shared by every economical developed country, that is given here clearly. Every health system in an economically developed society is nothing but every economically developed country. And a problem is nothing but here there are so many interrogatives, like what proportion of the country's capital and how resources are to be apportioned, and what are the diseases and disabilities and which forms of treatment. This is nothing but problem here. Now heading number 4 is the most suitable one for this section. Next, look at section B is already given in the example. No need to read section B for this set of questions. For the second and third set of questions, we'll focus on section B. First, please go to section C. Look at section C. Section C. However, at exactly the same time as this new realization of the finite character of healthcare resources was sinking in, an awareness of a contrary kind was developing in Western societies. That people have a basic right to health care as a necessary condition of a proper human life. Now this is our source sentence for this section, that people have a basic right to health care as a necessary condition of a proper human right. Now we'll see in the list, they're speaking about the connection between healthcare and other human rights. It is given clearly here. that people have a basic right to the healthcare as a necessary condition of a proper human life. Here they are speaking about healthcare and basic rights to healthcare. So if you see heading number one here, the connection between healthcare and other human rights. So for this one, heading number one is the most suitable one. Now please go to section D. Look at section D. If you see section D here, although the language of rights sometimes leads to confusion, by the late 1970s, it was recognized in most societies that people have a right to health care, though there has been considerable resistance in the United States to the idea that there is a formal right to health care. So it is also accepted that this right generates an obligation or duty for the state to ensure that adequate healthcare resources are provided out of the public purse. See here, they are speaking about the state and United States. We'll see here about state, I think heading number 3. See, the role of the state in healthcare, if you see here, it is given clearly. Even here also, the state has no obligation to provide a healthcare system itself, but to ensure that such a system is provided. Put another way, basically, in all these sentences, speaking about state and its role only, that means heading number 3 is the most suitable one for this section. Next, look at section E. Section E. So in this section again two paras are given. So you can take either first sentence of first para or first sentence of second para. Choice is yours. So for my flexibility, I would like to take first sentence of second para. See, as a consequence. So what is the meaning of consequence? Consequence means result, impact, implication, pitfalls, fallouts, dangers. So as a consequence, during the 1980s, the kind of doomsday scenario extrapolations about energy needs. Okay, here they are speaking about one impact or one consequence. Now we will check in the list. The connection is done. There is no information about market. State also done. Problem also done. Yes, the impact of recent change. It is given clearly. The meaning of consequence. This is nothing but relevant information about impact. Impact. So during the 1980s means in recent years. So answer is heading number 5. Next, please come to second set of questions. Here you have to match. Here A means between 1945 and 1950, B means between 1950 and 1980, and C means after 1980. Look at the first question. The realization that the resources of the national health systems were limited. So where is this information? If you see here, this information is given clearly in section B. Section B. See, section B, the new consciousness that there were also severe limits to healthcare resources was part of this general revelation of the obvious. And if you see this, they are speaking in 1950s and 1960s. So if you see here, 1950s and 1960s will come under this 1950 and 1980. That's what answer for this question is B. Next, a sharp rise. Next question, a sharp rise in the cost of healthcare. If you see here, I think in section E it is given clearly. Thus, in OECD countries as a whole, health costs increased from 3.8% of GDP in 1960 to 7.7% of GDP in 1980. So even this is also speaking about here, cost increased is nothing but in the question they have given sharp rise. Even this is also in the 1960 to 1980. That means even for this question also answer is B only. Next question. A belief that all healthcare resources the community needed would be produced by economic growth. So if you see, this information is given clearly in paragraph B. Look at paragraph B. Paragraph B. In the section B, this is given here, no? Looking back, it now seems, see here, it now seems quite incredible that in the national health system that emerged in many countries in the years immediately after the 1939 to 45 World War, it was assumed, from here onwards it is given clearly, it was assumed without question that all the basic health needs of any community, in our question they are speaking about community, could be satisfied at least in principle. So this is given in 1939 to 1945. That means here, if you see here, 1939 to 1945 means what? This is like between 1945 and 1950. Given clearly here. Not 1935, in many countries in the years immediately after 1935 to 1945 World War. So after 1945, not in the 1945, after 1945 means here. So 1945 to 1950. So for this question, answer is A. And look at 35th, an acceptance of the role of the state in guaranteeing the provision of health care. If you see here, impact of the role of state is given in section A, right? So we will see here. So here, role. See here, by the late 1970s. Here it is given clearly, by the late 1970s it was recognized in most societies that people have a right to health care. Right to health care. Here, an acceptance of the role of the state in guaranteeing the provision of health care. And it also accepted that this right generates an obligation or duty for the state to ensure that adequate health care resources are provided out of the public purse. This happened by late 1970s. That means late 1970s means 1950 and 1980. So even for this question also, answer is B. So this is about second set of questions. Now we will go to third set of questions. These are like as no, not given. So look at question number 36. Personal liberty and independence have never been regarded as directly linked to health care. So here in the question clearly given, personal liberty and independence have never been regarded directly to health care. Now we will see in the paragraph. So if you see in the paragraph, it is given in clearly in the section C. See here, people are not in a position to exercise. To exercise personal liberty. See in our question also, personal liberty is given. Personal liberty and to be self-determining. Self-determining in this context is nothing but independence. If they are poverty-stricken or deprived of basic education or do not live within a context of law and order. But the question is about whether it is directly linked to healthcare or not, that information is given in the next sentence clearly. See here, in the same way, basic healthcare is a condition of the exercise of autonomy. Here, autonomy is nothing but independence, but here they are linked to independence and they are linked to personal liberty. But in the question, they have given clearly, have never been regarded as directly linked to, but coming to paragraph, it is given clearly, they all are depend on each other. That's what answer for this question is no, because in the paragraph, contradictory information is given. Now look at question number 37. Healthcare came to be seen as a right at about the same time that the limits of healthcare resources became evident. So at the same time is more or less equal, both are happened. That means it is seen to be a right at the same time these healthcare resources became evident. Now we will check for this. See, here in the section it is given just at the same time. At the same time is nothing but here in the question they have given clearly at about same time. At about same time is nothing but just at the same time when it became obvious. When it became obvious is nothing but became evident that healthcare resources could not possibly meet the demands being made upon them. People were demanding that their fundamental right to healthcare be satisfied by the state. That is nothing but came to be seen as a right. So both happened at the same time. So that's what answer for this question is yes, because same meaning is given in both question and source. Now question number 38. In OECD countries, population changes have had an impact on healthcare costs in recent years. So this is also given clearly here. Thus, in OECD countries as a whole, health costs increased from 3.8% of GDP in 1960 to 7% of GDP in 1980, and it has been predicted that the proportion of health costs to GDP will continue to increase. Will continue to increase is nothing but costs in recent years, and some impact is there actually. That's what answer is yes for this question, because same meaning is given. Now look at question number 39. OECD governments have consistently underestimated the level of healthcare provision needed. So here the information about OECD is given, but there is no proper information about government have consistently underestimated. This information is not given. That's what answer for this question is simply not given. Next question. In most economically developed countries, the elderly will have to make special provision for their health care in the future. So if you see here in the paragraph, so in the question they are speaking about elderly. Elderly will have to make special provision for their health care in the future. But coming to paragraph, there is no information about elderly people and their special provision for their own belongings. So that's what even for this question also answer is not given, because no proper information is given in the whole passage. Thank you.